Hi friends, welcome to Shot with Big Shot with me, Geeta Modi. Today we meet a man who claims he has multi-passion disorder. He's an engineer by education but an actor by compulsion. He has travelled a tough road to reach where he is today, that is in the hearts of millions of people. Born and brought up in Surat, my guest of today does not need very big introduction because he's already made Surtis very proud of him. Every Surti relates to him as though he were their own brother or son or nephew or a friend. His movies like Lavni Bhavai, Ventilator and Beyar, to name a few, have given Gujarati mainstream cinema an absolutely new meaning. And it has become an experience to be viewed with pure admiration and joy. So please join me in welcoming this extremely grounded, very humble and practical son of Surat, our own Pratik Gandhi. Welcome Pratik to our show, Shot with Big Shot. We are so happy to have you with us today.
Thank you.
So happy to have you here.
Thank you.
Well, getting straight to the questions.
Yeah.
All the Surtis and Gujaratis, of course, know of your journey because you've become so popular. But just to update a few of them, we'd like to hear some of it through you.
Okay, so my journey has been that way, a very simple and a common journey is what I feel. Surat is my hometown.
Of course.
I come from a family of teachers. So okay. Everybody in my family used to be teachers, like my parents, my uncle, aunts, all the cousins, everybody. So that's the background that I've grown up with,
right.
And everybody was into music and arts that way.
Right.
So family ma ghana bada visharad, upantar visharad, shastriya sangeet,
wow.
And haveli sangeet.
Mm.
Ele aa bada j mahol ma uchryo hun. So art, different forms of art, theater, I guess it has grown with me and I've grown with theater is what I feel.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was always a part of theater activities in school. So I studied in Jivan Bharati Praruti Vidyalay till 7th standard, then 8th to 12th that I've studied in Bulka Bhavan School, where my father used to be a teacher.
Okay.
So I've studied, done my diploma mechanical from Gandhi College. So till then I was in Surat, and all this while with my studies I used to do theatres, school, inter-school competitions. And Surat maje Surat Municipal Corporation ni Triyanki Natya Spardha thai, so I was
it's
part
so
of
popular,
that also
yeah.
for almost 3 to 4 years. And then I went to Jalgaon for a graduation. So I've done my graduation in production engineering, which is mechanical in production engineering. And then I decided to pursue two things together, which I felt is common, uncommon that way, because a lot of people told me that why? I mean, you are an engineer, take up a job and get settled. But I always wanted to do theater, explore that world professionally also. And I thought Bombay is the only place where I get to do both
True.
These things together.
True.
So I went to Mumbai in 2004 and I started looking for theatre jobs. I started looking for opportunities in television also, because by then television has really become a big thing for actors.
Okay.
And I always wanted to explore films also.
Mm.
So that's how I landed in Bombay. I started working for National Productivity Council as a freelance consultant,
okay.
as an engineer, and started looking for jobs. I gave a lot of auditions,
of course.
Faced a lot of rejections also.
I'm sure and that is not true.
Yeah, and kept learning a lot of things.
Yeah, you do learn.
Then I landed up in Mumbai's experimental theatre circuit, which I guess is the best thing to happen to me.
It is.
And then I started actually working on my craft. I polished it to a level where I started getting good roles in experimental theatres. Then I took up a full-time job in corporate world to survive there in Mumbai. And so job helped me also select a better projects in theatre. That way, so I could actually, I consider myself as a lucky person who could do these two things together. And I guess I could achieve a good level in both these worlds, and at one point I had to decide whether now this or that, because then I started having opportunity losses at both the ends.
True.
So then I took a call after. So Beyar also I did with my job, my first film.
True.
Then Wrong Side Raju in 2016 also that I did with my job. So humari badi je varshni rajao ine rajao bachavi rakhto to ki kyare kavo kaik moko aavshe ne vaparshu. So my family suffered, that's a separate thing, but so I banne filmo evi rite kari ane finally in 2016 I took a decision to be a full time actor.
So these two were both your favorite things, you wanted to do both, right? Yeah. From the beginning when you
so
left
there are
Surat.
Few others, but yeah, these two yeah. things were top of
were
the list
top, and you had to choose one. So was it a tough choice, I mean, which to leave and which to keep? And
yeah, see, it's a very tough emotional choice that way, because what has happened in my corporate job also that I climbed the ladder very fast there. Ah. I joined as a junior engineer, then as became a manager, senior manager,
okay.
deputy general manager was the last post that I had.
Wow.
And the next promotion would have put me in senior management cadre.
Oh.
And today's corporate world that way is very demanding.
Of course.
So the responsibilities were of a different level altogether, that my job required a lot of traveling also.
Sure.
So I used to travel to 3-4 different places all over India in a month. And with that, I used to do theatre also.
So it takes a lot out of
It takes a lot out yeah. of me. But it was a fun journey for me. So corporate job is a secured job that way.
It is.
That a good yeah. amount is coming to your account.
Of course.
In the first week every of month, every month. Yeah. And surviving in Bombay, living in Bombay is not
it
a joke
is expensive,
that way.
Because it
is. So I went to Mumbai from Surat with nothing in my hand, only with this one degree and one passion is what was
of
with
course,
me.
Yeah.
So having your own house, I yes. got married, I have a daughter, my parents were there, my brother is there. So having a family to support and creating your own space in Bombay was not an easy task. So I think this was a very, very tough decision when I took in 2016, where I was about to go to a higher management cadre in job. And at the same time, I was getting a lot of offers for the films, theatre, from Gujarat and even from Hindi.
Yeah.
So now that was a time where I had to decide, because if I wanted to continue in the job, I should be changing the companies, I should be more yeah. mobile now.
Being more focused.
Like, mare Mumbai chhodu pade, international job offers levi pade, because by then I had already turned down two big offers.
Oh.
Like, pachi mane eu thatu tu kya to aa karu ne kya full time aa karu, have evo time aavi gayo to. But I guess my passion pulled me this side and my family supported me big time. So that's it.
And you never repented it after
no,
that?
No. I have never. In fact, that was the biggest reason that I took this call, that I never want to repent.
Yeah.
And I don't want to blame anybody in my life. So if anybody is to be blamed, it's me, because it's my decision.
Okay. So what are the 5 attributes you can say which have contributed to your success, which you have?
Oh. So 5 attributes, if I have to select, I guess there's this constant passion to learn has helped me in whatever I've done. The other thing is there is a constant thing which keeps going in my mind is to add value.
Yeah.
So right. to add value in whatever I do. I mean, it can be anything. It can be a silliest thing, or
course,
it can
yeah.
be a small game that I'm playing.
Yeah. Right.
It can be play that I'm doing, it can be a script that I'm reading, or even helping somebody or just being with somebody. So wherever I constantly feel to add value.
Mm.
And I guess that has helped me a lot grow as a different person.
True.
The other thing is not to have any baggage and walk light
that
on your feet.
Is very important.
Yeah, that's very important, because as an actor also
yeah.
and as for that may, and yeah, as a person also. Because theater ma shun thai ke tamne tyar and tyar taaliyo mbade, laughters mbade, then everybody would want to say ke you are best, bahu j mast kari, bahu maja aavi. Pana atli badhi vastu ne jo am constant bag ma bharto raun, then I guess my back will be very heavy.
Heavy.
So I guess aap badhu prem thi lai ne, you keep it there and then move light on your feet. So I guess that helps me a lot. The right. other thing is, I guess, the warmth that I've constantly got from the family and all the people around. So
yeah, family support is
family support and
is
everything.
The final ultimate.
Yeah, so I think so. What I'm getting is I'm giving. So I guess that a warm behavior everywhere helps me a lot, getting along with people and so getting to do a different thing, I guess.
True. So I think we've covered 5.
Yeah. We covered 4. The 5th, I guess, is the energy that I carry.
Yes, that I've always noticed.
Like yeah, so I don't know, because I never noticed this. A lot of people told me and then I started realizing.
You do have
but this energy is helping me.
Yes. It's a very positive energy
yeah,
and a very very friendly the minute you come in.
So I guess that my engineering thing helps me a lot. That whenever you see a problem, start thinking about solutions. So it's a different kick that you get. So problems don't demoralize you or disappoint you.
Yeah,
it in fact excites you. Okay, now there'll be a solution.
True. So if you had to start, say, your life all over again, you think you would have taken a different route?
Oh, this one is tricky, man. Yeah, it's a very brilliant question, though. So, yeah, okay. If I had to start the entire journey of my life, I would rather go with the same route, because each and every step that I've walked, each and everything that I've done has taught me a lot of things.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, just to add to this, when I went to Bombay, I have done a lot of different things, lots and lots of different things. So, outside a mall, I used to sell cockroach pastes also.
Okay.
A cockroach repellent kind of a paste for that extra money that I wanted. I've done a lot of comparing shows for kids and corporates also. So just to explore myself further.
Whatever you got and came.
I've constantly done something or the other, and that has helped me
to grow as a person.
To grow as a person also, and that has helped me to grow as an actor also.
True. So true. I think it's very practical. In this field of cinema, we always hear this word nepotism, you know. So have you faced that, or have you lost out because somebody was somebody's something?
So I've had a good enough amount of rejections that way in my earlier days. I don't know whether it is because of nepotism or something else, but I guess everybody goes through this kind of rejections, and that teaches you a lot to grow further. So that's how I take it normally. But there is no particular incident that I can remember of it. But to add to this particular thing, see, when I was a kid, when we were in school, so there are a lot of competitions. And I mane evi te hati ke darek competition mari. I told you, like, multiple passion disorder. Baddhu j karvu hoy. પછી વેધર યુ વિન ઓર યુ લૂઝ બટ યુ વોન્ટ ટુ બી અ પાર્ટ ઓફ
યુ હેવ ટુ બી અ પાર્ટ
તો કોન્સ્ટન્ટ આ બધું કરતા કરતા સ્કૂલમાં તો એવું થતું હતું કે હું દરેક કોમ્પિટિશનમાં પાર્ટ લઉં મારો ક્યારેય કશામાં નંબર ના આવે
બટ યુ વર ધેર
સો હા સો યુ વોન્ટ ટુ બી ધેર યુ વોન્ટ ટુ ડુ ઇટ અગેન એન્ડ અગેન અને ત્યારે આવું બધું ઘણા બધાને પેરેન્ટ્સ કહેતા હતા અને બધા કહેતા હોય ને ત્યારે સાંભળ્યા હતા કે તો આને આવું હોય ને એટલે આને નંબર આપે આને આવું હોય ને સો માય ફાધર ટોટ મી અ બ્રિલિયન્ટ થિંગ આઈ ગેસ હી સેડ સી ઇફ એનીબડી વોન્ટ્સ ટુ ઇવન ડુ પાર્શિયાલિટી સો they will be able to do it if you give them a room. So you perform to a level where even if they want to do it, they can't do it.
True.
So there is a gap in you. So just work on yourself. I guess and that particular thing helps you a lot.
Yeah.
Think differently.
The introspection.
Constant. If I've lost something, so it is me to be blamed. કઈક તો કાચું મેં જ રાખ્યું છે. મેને enough કારણ નહીં આપ્યો હોય કદાચ મને સિલેક્ટ કરવાના.
So true. You are a small town boy. Into this big bad world of cinema, Mumbai. Did you feel at any time you were a misfit, or it was, you know, not your place? Because the psyche is very different in Bombay in Surat. So people are more professional, your people are more friendly. So everything is different.
In the beginning, I felt ki yara khub judu world che. I mean, how do you do this and that? In fact, pehla be tran audition vakate to when I went there, so I was always this lean, this kind of a guy. ત્યાં તો ગયો ને જોયું તો બધા 6.5 feet ઓલ નોર્થ ઇન્ડિયન્સ એન્ડ ઓલ સો ધેર બાયસેપ્સ આર લાઈક માય થાઈઝ મેન એટલે આપણને એમ થાય કે અચ્છા મેં હું અહીંયા આવ્યો છું જ ખોટો આઈ એમ નોટ ગોઈંગ ટુ ગેટ સિલેક્ટેડ ઇઝ વોટ ધ ફર્સ્ટ થિંગ દેટ યુ ગેટ બટ સ્લોલી એન્ડ સ્ટડીલી આઈ લર્ન દેટ ઇટ્સ નોટ અબાઉટ ધીઝ થિંગ્સ ઇટ્સ અબાઉટ યોર ક્રાફ્ટ બટ યા સો આઈ ગેટ એન્ડ બીંગ અ સ્મોલ ટાઉન પર્સન હેઝ હેલ્પ મી બિકોઝ યોર ટોલરન્સ લેવલ્સ આર ડિફરન્ટ And you are always hungry to learn, you are always hungry to absorb. Is what I've seen with a lot of other people also who are coming from small town. Because you want to do something big. So I guess that attitude helped me a lot.
Oh, that is such a wonderful way of putting it. Okay, so Pratik, how important is self-motivation to you? Do you need to practice self-motivation in this industry?
Yeah, I guess self-motivation is needed every time, every single minute.
I'm sure.
Not only for actors, for everybody is what I feel. But yeah, in this particular field, you constantly have to generate an energy that keeps you going, that helps you be positive at all the fronts. Because one rejection for an actor means a lot in the sense that there are a lot of people who fall in self-doubt And that self-doubt is a killer thing for any artist.
Sometimes a film may not work.
Yeah, sometimes a film may not work. Sometimes that there are shows which are going wrong, you know. And the live audience, so they does give their reactions there and there itself.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean that you are bad, you are not good enough. It's just that there are some moments which are weak, or some moments which you are not able to work out properly.
Yeah.
But yeah, so self-motivation, there is no particular method that I have. But the only thing is that there is a constant urge to improve, which makes you positive, is what I have learned. Add value, I want to add value, I want to learn something, I want to improve, I want to improve. And quality is not a destination in any case, you know, it's a constant journey.
Of course.
So there is something constantly that you can add.
True.
And art is any which way is not supposed to be perfect.
Otherwise it wouldn't be
art. Yeah, it wouldn't be art, right? Because it has a lot of views, everybody can look at differently. So I guess these things help me generate that energy and be positive every day.
Do you have any mentors, or you were your own coach?
So I guess life is the biggest mentor that I had, each and everything. There are a lot of people who've met me at different juncture of
stages,
life.
Stages, yeah.
And so their one sentence, their one word, their one gesture has taught me a lot of things. So I would say I have a lot of mentors, and I keep meeting mentors every day, I feel.
Yeah, so you are learning from every person you meet. So you also write, direct, and you know, do all these things, other passions, as you say.
Yeah.
So have you used any of it in your movies or plays?
So actor to director, or director to actor, I guess is a very organic journey for a person. Because acting and directing and things go hand in hand.
It does.
So recently, last year, I have directed a play called Satari Equis. So there are seven different monologues which are female oriented. So we call it womanologues. Yeah, so I have directed seven females in seven different scripts, which are 15 to 16 minutes each. And we did multiple shows also. So that's my first debut in theatre as a director. And this year also, I'm looking forward to direct another play. Film, I don't know, I have not thought of it as yet, but sooner or later it will happen, I feel.
So, the stage, it was first a big stage, then it was the smaller screen in theatre. Now it has become, you know, the television or the digital platform, the Netflix just on your phones. So it's just getting smaller and smaller, but the opportunities are just growing.
Yeah.
So what do you feel about this whole process? You think it's...
See, it's a very, very interesting stage, a very interesting phase for an entertainment industry, specifically all the artists, because the reach has gone deeper.
It has.
There are new mediums which have come up. So as an actor or as an artist, I believe in exploring all different mediums.
True.
Because each medium has its own different requirement. Matlab aap jab stage par natak kariye ya radio natak kariye to ye judu se.
Right.
Kaan ke ma, it's not audio visual, it's only audio. Stage is different.
Different.
Movie is different. Television is different. That way now, this digital platforms are different.
It's different. Short
different
story,
in the sense, the way you approach the character and the script and the entire product differs. Now the audience is also changing every day.
It is.
So audience, pehla 5 days ni test match par thi, one day par thi 2020, ave mane lagitu nathi ke divas dur se jare 5 over ni match jo. Because the attention span
is become less.
Increasing. Decreasing.
Decreasing.
Matlab dar 3G minute hai to you want to reach out to your WhatsApp.
Yeah, true.
So avama, when you're performing, how can I hook the audience to my eyes and take them with me for 2 hours of play or a 30 minute of a script is what a challenge.
True.
That's a big challenge that we are facing.
Short movies have
also come up.
Yeah.
And I guess short movies are doing a brilliant business.
Job. Now there are so many competitions and so many things where you send them. And
but yeah, so a good time for actors to explore. There is a lot of work and a tough time that way, because you have to constantly reinvent yourself.
Reinvent.
Your craft also.
True. So you have a sort of a work-life balance, family life, work life, or like at this stage, you have got so much work, so it's just work and nothing else.
Yeah. So work-life balance has always been an issue in my life, because I don't see myself as a good person to do that. I'm very bad at it. I'm still learning. And I guess my wife can answer this better than me.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Because I guess I've sold
soon
her
your
time.
Daughter also would.
Yeah.
I'm sure.
So I've sold their time all the time.
Right.
All this while, because earlier with the job, then and theater, then job, theater and films together. So now theater and films together.
But I think your wife would understand because she's from the industry.
Yeah, so as an actor, she understands. So as a wife and as a partner, beyond a point, you don't want to understand.
Yeah.
That I understand everything, but where is my time?
True, that's true.
A very valid question.
True.
So I'm struggling there a bit, but I think I'll catch up.
Yeah, you'll get there. Okay. So now we are going to do a sort of a series of questions. We call it small shots with big shot.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So it's just a little thing which you can answer just in a line or in a word also.
Perfect.
Okay. So we do that now.
Okay.
Do you have a favorite quote?
So my favorite quote is about the luck.
Okay.
So luck is when preparation meets opportunity.
Good. That's nice. Are you afraid of anything?
Yes, I am afraid of one particular thing is that I don't want to be afraid.
Okay.
And that I don't want to be afraid is a bigger fear, you know. Because there is a brilliant thing that I've read somewhere that anything we do in life is either driven by love or fear.
True. Very true.
If it is driven by love, it's all positive. There is always hope. If it is love by love, it is driven by fear, then the negative energy creeps in.
It does.
So I am always afraid of that fear that I don't want to be afraid of anything.
One thing which you always carry.
One thing that I always carry is the positive energy.
And one thing which you don't want to share.
Oh, one thing that I don't want to share is my brush.
I'm sure that is there. Any director you want to work with?
Oh, there are lots and lots of directors that I want to work with. But as of now, immediately, I guess Anurag Kashyap that I want to work with soon.
You enjoy?
What I enjoy? Exercising.
Great.
Yeah, workout.
To you, friendship is?
Friendship is everything. It's life.
And love is?
Love is eternity. I guess it's beyond life.
True. Your favorite cuisine?
Gujarati thali. Gujarati gharnu jamvanu. Very orthodox.
Your favorite holiday spot?
Oh, I'm yet to find though. Okay. But yeah, my favorite holiday, it's still house.
Okay.
Yeah, that, I don't.
Yeah,
I,
so that must be a holiday for
yeah,
you. Because you travel
yeah,
so much.
So that's where the biggest tiff is.
True.
Ghar jaate ho to bolte hain, main bahar nahi ja sakta.
Okay. Your choice again, your films, stage or the digital
okay,
platform.
So theatre has always been my passion and my first love. So I guess theatre. Films, digital platforms, yeah, but theater, yeah. So theater
is your first.
Because I feel that theater is actor's gym. That's where I get to learn my craft.
And the last two, your favorite actor?
Oh, my favorite actor? So I really look up to Amitabh Bachchan, the way he's had his journey.
True.
Because he reinvented himself at correct time. And even till today, he can fit in any of
anything
the characters.
Yeah, he's like.
And
water.
It's not easy.
Yeah.
After becoming Amitabh Bachchan, you still fit into any character. It's not easy, I guess.
And your favorite actress?
My favorite actress? So, Konkana Sen Sharma, I loved her.
Okay.
She's brilliant in a lot of films.
So great. It was wonderful talking to you, Pratik. Hope you remember us with this little token of appreciation for
oh my
removing
God
time and coming. Thank you so much.
Thank you very
this
much.
This is our Shot with Big Shot hamper and we have a cup.
Oh,
which
wow
you can, which has your picture and you can have your coffee and remember us.
Thank you very much. That's so thoughtful.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you very much.
So friends, before we leave today, I want to take away one good lesson from Pratik's journey. That is to keep reinventing, to keep growing, to be positive, to learn and to always absorb things all the time. This is what makes you grow. This is what makes anybody grow. And I think from Pratik's journey, we can also see that whether you're from a small town or wherever, if your craft is good, you will always make a place for yourself somewhere. Or at least wherever you want to make a place. So friends, aaj maine bahut maza aayi Pratik sath baat karwani and I hope you enjoyed it as well. But I would like to take at least some tips and some lesson and give it to you. I'm sure you also have heard it. At least be very sure that you keep reinventing yourself. Be very sure to keep absorbing things and learning at every stage and every phase of your life. I'm sure as you grow, you become much more confident in whatever you are doing. with Pratik, he was a small town boy. So if he can do it, anybody can. Whether you're a small town person or from a big town, your craft is important. And that makes you what you are and takes you to wherever you have to go. So with this, I take your leave. Until next time, take care, stay fit. See you soon.